In this video, we delve into the art of creating an engaging photo montage in CapCut using static images. Often we find ourselves with a collection of photos, each capturing a unique moment or perspective. And while these images are powerful on their own, transforming them into a video montage can elevate their impact, telling a story that's more dynamic and emotionally resonant. Whether it's due to the lack of video footage or the desire to repurpose existing photos, this approach allows you to craft a compelling video using those images. So let's learn how to make these still photos come alive. So let's open CapCut, and then we're gonna start a new project. Now, I already created a folder with all the photos that I wanna use in my montage so that it's easier instead of having to scroll throughout my camera roll and finding those. So we are gonna find that folder. Now in this tab, because it's videos, I don't have anything because inside that folder, I don't have any video. So we need to change tab and go into photos. And right now I can see all the photos that I have in that folder. And now I'm gonna start importing all my photos. Probably gonna pick 9 or 10. Yes, these 9, I think they're okay. And then when I'm ready, I'm just gonna click on add. Now we have all our photos in our timeline, but then I wanna show you that if we scroll at the end, we'll still have the CapCut ending. So this time I'm gonna delete it again, but now I wanna show you a better way on how to get rid of this ending forever. And to do so, we're just gonna exit this project, and then we're gonna go into settings. And here you can see add default ending, and we just need to disable this, and we're gonna tap on this card. There you go. And now we can exit the settings, and next time you're gonna open a project, you're not gonna have the CapCut ending anymore. Now, while we're here, let's rename this one into photo montage. So we're gonna select all, and then we're gonna type photo montage. Click okay. Then we can enter again the project. Now the first thing that I wanna do is modify the aspect ratio, because CapCut generated the sequence based on the aspect ratio of the first clip imported. And in our case, it was this photo, which is a 3x4. So now let's go back to the original menu and we tap on aspect ratio. Here we can choose whatever aspect ratio we want. And in our case, we're just gonna pick 9x16, which is a common format for Instagram Reels, TikTok, so on and so forth. So we're gonna tap on done. And now we can see that we have black bars on top and on the bottom of the photo. And if we select the photo, we'll be able to pinch in or pinch out to zoom in or zoom out on the photo. Then if you want, you can fill the frame with the photo, just like so. Then we can move on to the next one and do the same thing. But then when I look at this photo, for example, if I make it as big as the screen, I notice that I'm cutting out the painting on the left, and also the person on the right is a little bit too close to the edge of the screen. So maybe I wanna keep this normal. But then if I don't wanna use the black background, I can actually change it and adjust it in a different way. And to do so, I'm just gonna go in the main menu, then I'm gonna scroll until I see background. I'm gonna tap on background, and here I have a few options. I can change the color, add another image, blur the image that you have right now, and also change for a branded background. If I go on color, for example, I can choose a different color. Let's say red, orange, or maybe yellow. But then I don't like really any of these colors. So we're just gonna use the black one for now, because instead I wanna try to go on blur, and then I'm gonna use this one. Basically, it created a copy in the background of the image that we have on top, and it blurred it out. Now let's click on the check mark on the bottom right corner, and then let's move on to the next photo. I can see that this one is the same thing. It has all the black part on the top and the bottom, but I don't like it, so I'm gonna go into blur, and I'm gonna click on the first option that I have. I can also browse through the second or third option, and I think I'm gonna probably go with the third option. Yeah, I like that. And now if I wanna do the same process with all the photos that we have, I'm just gonna click apply to all. And now all clips will have this effect if they're not filling the frame. Let's click on the check mark. So now let's keep going. Now it's time to add music. So let's move the playhead at the beginning. Then we're gonna click on audio, and we're gonna click on sounds. Now we just need to browse in the categories and find the music that we like. We're gonna go into vlog and then listen to a couple of tracks. And I think this one is gonna fit. So I'm gonna click on the plus icon to add it to my timeline. And right now, as we did before, we just need to trim again the photos to match the music. So let's listen back and decide where we wanna trim the first photo. I think I'm gonna try to match it here. This looks fine. And then I'm gonna keep going with all the other photos. Now I trimmed the clip to match the music and I just want to delete the ending of this music. So I want to go at the very end of our sequence, then I'm going to select the music, I'm going to split it and then delete the ending. Now let's watch back the overall sequence together. This sequence looks nice, but I think we can improve it quite a bit by adding some movement. And we're gonna do this by using keyframes. Keyframes in video editing are specific points where you set the start or end of a change in a video element like position, size, or color. It's like marking the points in your video where you want changes to begin or stop. The software then automatically creates the smooth transition between these keyframes. And in this video specifically, we're adding motion to static images for a dynamic effect. Let me show you how to do that in CapCut. Let's move our playhead at the very beginning of the sequence. Now we're gonna zoom in by pinching in with two fingers, then we're gonna select the first image. And to add the first keyframe, we're gonna hit the icon next to the undo button. And now we can see that a keyframe appeared in the first image. Then what we do is we're going to scroll at the end of the first image, just like here. And then we're going to use one finger to move the photo a little bit towards the left. And now we created an animation, so let's check it back. We're going to go from point A, where we started our keyframe, to point B, where we end our animation. So let's check it back together. We're going to click on play. CapCut automatically created this smooth movement. Then we can proceed with more keyframes on the following clip. We're gonna add a keyframe at the beginning, then we're gonna move at the end of the photo, and we're just gonna increase the dimension a tiny bit of this image and maybe slide it towards the bottom part of the screen. And now we created an animation, again, that moves in towards the library. And I think I'm happy with that. And now I'm gonna do this with the rest of the clips. But this one, for example, I really like the composition that we have right there. So we're gonna go towards the end of the photo, just like so, and then we're gonna add a keyframe at the end of the clip, meaning that this composition will be our result at the end of the clip. So we're gonna add a keyframe and then we need to decide a starting position. So we're gonna go at the beginning of this clip, we're gonna select it and then we can move it maybe towards this side, just like that. So let's look at it back. Okay, it's not bad, but I think I have a little bit too much foreground. But now we're gonna select this clip. And in case I wanna add more motion at the end of the clip, I just need to make sure to be towards the end until the keyframe becomes red. This means that whatever adjustment I'm gonna make is gonna affect this keyframe. Because in case you are not selecting that keyframe and maybe you're here, you're gonna add automatically a keyframe if you do a different adjustment. So for example, I'm gonna zoom in and then drag it down. Now I created another keyframe that is gonna affect the overall movement of the clip. There you go. But I don't want this one, so I'm just gonna delete by pressing again on the keyframe icon. There you go. And now I'm gonna select the last keyframe just by positioning the playhead in this position. And now I can zoom in and drag it down. There you go. And now I updated this movement on top of whatever we had before in that keyframe. So let's have a look at it back together. Yes, and I think this looks great. I just wanna let you notice that if you are on a red keyframe, the keyframe icon has a minus next to it. Whereas if you're not on a keyframe, then you have a plus, which means that you can add a keyframe. So this is another way on how you can check whether you're positioned right to add a keyframe or to adjust an existing one. And then I'm gonna keep going with all the other photos. Now that we've finished the sequence, I wanna show you another tool that could be useful in the future. Let's say I wanna add a little bit more movement in this clip, in this photo. And maybe I wanna make it appear from the outside of the frame towards the inside. To do so, I'm just gonna add another keyframe right here. There you go. Which means that I want in this moment, this photo to be in this position. Then I'm gonna go at the very beginning, right here, and then I'm gonna position the photo out of the frame, just like so. So now if we play back the clip, we can see that the photo enters the frame, but the speed is very linear. But I wanna make it smoother, and to do so, I'm just gonna position the playhead between the two clips, and then I'm gonna click on graphs, the icon next to the keyframe icon. You can click on it, and here you'll be able to choose among different presets for changing the speed of the keyframes. The ease-in will make the beginning of the animation slower, whereas the ease-out will make the end of the animation slower. And we have three different options that correspond to different speed of the effect. So for example, we can pick the ease-out one for our animation. We're gonna tap on it, and then we can review the animation. There you go. And now you see that changing quite a bit compared to before. Before it used to be very linear, now it's more smooth. Then if you're happy with the result, you're just gonna click on the check mark and that's it. Then one last thing that we can do is to fade out the music. So we're gonna tap on the music, then we're gonna tap on fade, and here we can fade out. This will decrease the volume gradually towards the end. So now let's zoom back. You can see that now it appeared this shadow on the music, which means that the volume is going lower and lower and lower. All right, now let's watch back the overall sequence together. We're gonna drag the playhead at the beginning, and then we can tap on play. By mastering these tools, not only have you learned to breathe life into static images, but you've also gained skills that extend beyond photo montages. Remember, the techniques of aspect ratio adjustments, resizing, cropping, keyframes, and changing background are just as applicable and beneficial when working with video clips. You now possess a wider array of tools to create more captivating and interesting videos, regardless of whether you're working with photos or video footage. Keep exploring these techniques in your projects, and you'll discover new ways to enhance the visual storytelling of any medium. I'll see you in the next lesson. This video gave you a sneak peek into what our iPhone Video Editing Academy has in store. Delve deeper into mastering advanced video editing techniques, from initial cuts in the Photos app to creating sophisticated scenes in CapCut. Whether you are a beginner or looking to up your video editing game, this course equips you with everything you need to make your project stand out. Join me as we explore the art of video editing, ensuring your content captures the essence of your creativity. Are you ready to elevate your editing skills? Check out the full course through the link in the description. I'll see you there.